Cryonics has been around for more than 60 years, but recently it's been getting more and more attention as billionaires from the Silicon Valley start to look at it as a real possibility to cheat death. The technology to put people into hibernation is not fictional. Even today, we can freeze people with terminal diseases and put them in a state of suspended animation for an indefinite time until a cure is found. One tiny problem though, we are not sure if we can wake them up.
This is Bertalan Meshko, and you're watching the channel of the Medical Futurist.
The use of cryogenic temperatures is already mainstream in healthcare. Cryotherapy is used in an effort to relieve muscle pain, sprains, and swelling after soft tissue damage or surgery. It's a huge advancement in healthcare, just ask any athletes. But the big discovery in cryogenics still lies ahead. It's cryosleep. Cryosleep seems to be an overused trope and an easy shortcut for sci-fi films and literature. But if we could make it work, it would really be a game changer, from saving terminally ill patients to solving one of the main problems of interstellar travels. And there are many attempts to make it a reality. An Atlanta-based startup, SpaceWorks Enterprises, works with NASA to develop a stasis chamber. The chamber lowers the body temperature to 32 Celsius and creates mild hypothermia. And with multiple sessions, a chamber like that could be a huge advancement in space travel. But it's not suspended animation, it's only a deep sleep. And in case we want to travel light years, we need to come up with something better. For that, you need cryogenics. Originally, the idea was simple. We cool down the bodies close to minus 200 Celsius and place them in a container of liquid nitrogen. The first person to be cryopreserved was Dr. James Bedford in 1967. He died of kidney cancer, but his will was to be put into a cryo chamber in hopes that one day in the future, doctors will be able to bring him back. But there is one big problem. The trouble with cryosleep and cryopreservation is that our cells are filled with water, and when you freeze water, it expands and forms crystals which irreversibly damage the body.
How'd you solve the icing problem?
Icing problem?
Might want to look into it.
The hope is that future scientists will be able to fix that and reanimate people without, well, basically killing them. Nevertheless, scientists of today are not sitting around either. At Alcor, the largest cryonics organization in the world, they already use a process called vitrification. They replace the water in the cells with an anti-freeze agent. So when the tissues are cooled to cryogenic temperatures, instead of crystallizing into ice, the chemicals clump together and become solid, molecularly similar to glass. And this new glass form prevents the cells from bursting and theoretically holds them in stasis forever. It's still a completely unproven technology, and it's mostly based on hopes and dreams, but for those who can afford it, it's at least a fighting chance. A number of people choosing to sign up is increasing every year. Today there are nearly 300 cryogenically frozen people in the US and 50 in Russia. There are even more than 30 pets at Alcor's chambers.
So are these heavily insulated? Are these basically giant thermoses?
Exactly. Just room temperature, a little bit cool to the touch.
Yeah.
It's not... Inside is extremely cold, minus 196 C, minus 320 Fahrenheit.
The irony is, unless we go under cryopreservation, we won't live to see if it ever works. Those who do go under, just maybe, but as for now, as harsh as it sounds, cryosleep is mainly just science fiction.